Obviously, I'm one of five. No, one of six, sorry. Sorry to my brother.
Talk about your love of football growing up.
Well, I used to sort of hang around with my uncles. You know, they were a lot older than me. Try and play one bounce and wally with them, and they'd always tell me to go and play with people my own age. I didn't sort of at that young age see myself getting to where I've got to, you know, until I started getting into a team and stuff like that, and then that's when sort of I thought, right, okay, this is something I want to do for a career, and got the passion for it then, yeah.
I read that you used to play in the cages around Coventry and that you nicknamed one Wembley. Is that yeah. True? What were the cages like there?
Well, yeah, the cages come at a later date when the area, you know, come up a little bit and yeah. Started building around there. At first, it was just like a gas boiler sort of wall. Right. We painted a goal on there, just literally lovely lines of white paint. And that was like Wembley, and everyone would play in this like little court. And you know, it was stones and everything around, but yeah, it's basically it. 1v1, everyone 1v1, and you go through to the next round. And that's where we sort of, all the people around the area, all different ages, I think there was girls playing as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone just sort of come together and sort of just had a bit of fun. So, obviously, I'm one of five. No, one of six, sorry. Sorry to my brother.
Just forgot one of his own brothers.
Yeah, so I'm one of six.
Yeah. Definitely one of six.
Definitely one of six.
Not one of seven.
No, one of six. And yeah, obviously, single mom, so it's difficult for her to sort of get me back and forth to training. So when I got the opportunity to go in, I was going with one of the guys who sort of lived 20 minutes away. And it was very serious at such a young age. And for me, I just wanted to have fun, enjoy it with my friends. So yeah, I took a time out, went back to Sunday League and played that for a little bit longer. As I was growing up, they kept trying to come back and get me to go in and stay in. But it wasn't until I got a bit older and they said, one of the scouts would pick me up for training.
What age is this?
This was probably 15,
right,
I'd say.
Okay. So an important part of your development, of course. Yeah.
Definitely. So he's basically said to me, you know, I was going on trial at different places. I went on trial at Forest, said I weren't good enough. Went on trial at West Brom, said I weren't good enough. Went on trial then at Coventry, had like a trial game. And yeah, scored a hat-trick against Stoke, I think it was, in this little friendly. They offered me a contract straight away, but I said, listen, only on one condition, basically, if I can get a lift back and forth to training.
You said that the amount of brothers, sisters that you had, mm-hmm. and single mum, how proud a moment was that for them when you're playing for Coventry and you're getting your loan moves and it looks like that is going to be the path that you take as a footballer?
Yeah, they're all holding their hands out like that.
I'm joking. I'm only joking.
Obviously for them, you know, it's massive playing for your hometown. You know, they all used to come and watch my games and things like that. And when I was breaking through at Coventry, you know, I made my debut at the Ricoh Arena. I supported them growing up as a kid, so it was massive for me. And obviously, like proud for sort of, yeah, everyone, even my granddad and things like that, you know, they're always down the social club, got it on the sky, on the big screen, and everyone in there cheering away, so it was nice, yeah.
Love that.
The percentage of players that actually turn pro, even from academies, is so small. Are you always thinking, what is my backup if it doesn't quite work out?
No, I didn't have, you know, I'm not the brightest spark in the box, you know, so for me...
I wasn't saying that.
It's a case of, basically sort of, for me, I was, you know, obviously I put all my eggs in one basket really, and was like, I either make it or I don't, and then obviously if I don't make it, then I'll think about what I'm gonna do afterwards, you know. I had thoughts about being a PE teacher and things like that, but I always, like I say, just put everything into football and thought, right, this is my sole focus now. If I make it, then at least I'll give everything to this. Yeah. Obviously, it's a humbling experience, but then you get, you know, big centre-halves that sort of are not too bothered about their diet, you know, they're a bit more larger than usual.
And a bit more physical, mate.
Exactly, yeah. So then, you know, you're in a 50-50 with them and you're getting lifted, basically. So it's one of those things, I guess, like I say, it's gonna toughen you up and strengthen you mentally and physically, but also it helped you improve tactically. You know, Bournemouth obviously showed interest and it was the next step for me.
Yeah.
I always believed I'd get to the Premier League and wanted to, but then obviously, backing it up is another thing. So I was in League One, you know, scoring my goals, and I thought, right, okay, I want to get, you know, improve and go higher. So I felt like the Championship was probably the next step for me to then establish myself. Bournemouth's plans were to get to the Premier League within 2 years. It matched mine, so it was a good fit. You know, I felt like this was the place for me to improve. And then within our first season, obviously got goals in the Championship, which was nice. And then we got promoted.
Talk to us about your first game for Bournemouth in the Premier League and what that meant to you. Because was that one of the things you dreamt of as a kid?
Yeah, definitely.
Being a Premier League player.
Definitely. I got here and it was like, right, okay, you know, this is what you've dreamt about all this time, and now it's trying to make a statement in this league. You know, you're watching great players week in, week out. Forget everything that's going on outside of sort of the dressing room, outside in the league. Just focus on game by game, and you know, whoever you're playing against, whether it's just play against the opposition, you know, not the badge.
Throughout your career, you've had a few injuries. Mm-hmm. How would you say you've come back from them and fought back so well to where you are now?
Yeah, I feel like obviously I've come back from them well, but that's from probably my mentality, you know.
Okay.
First and foremost, obviously wanting to come back to the same, you know, level you was before. So I'm always sort of making sure that I can improve. And, you know, also sort of not wanting to go back to where I come from, if you get what I mean.
Yeah.
So that's always been my drive. When you're getting set back and you get an injury, people are writing you off saying, is he going to come back the same for their career? Obviously, when you have an ACL, it goes downhill. And I'm like, no, that's not happening to me. You know, I'm making sure I'm going to keep going on the up. That was crazy because, you know, I'm working hard, and there was talk before I got injured about call-ups and things like that. And then it's like, right, you've had that sort of attention before, but now it's about putting it, you know, in something concrete. And then ultimately the call-up came. I thought, I'm going to just go enjoy the experience, you know, embrace it. And I found out, you know, I think it was the Tuesday that I was going to be playing, thinking, Jesus, I've gone from sort of, you know, playing sort of down there in Wembley to actually going to be playing at Wembley. And I think it was on telly as well, which was even more nice for the people that couldn't get down. And yeah, you know, when you start in your game, you know you've probably got at least 60, 70 minutes. So I'm thinking, all I want is one chance playing, chance comes, goes. And I'm like, no. But I'm thinking, right, stay focused. You know, you've still got however many times to go. And I think, eventually you got the goal and, you know, I was buzzing.
Callum, just finally, I read that things can be quite different for you because you're into football and a bit of kickboxing as a kid. So you chose football. What happened with the kickboxing? Tell us about that.
So I'd done it as growing up, you know, just to sort of as a self-defence thing for around my area. Right. Got to sort of 14, 15, started going on football trials. They started colliding and clashing with the days I did kickboxing and the days I did football. So obviously I was playing on a Saturday as opposed to a Sunday. Kickboxing was always on the Saturday, so I had to choose basically. I only had three fights, and I think it was, and they were like, oh, I think you could really, you know, progress in kickboxing. So it was a decision to make, really, what I thought I could progress in the most and what brought in the most money. So I was like,
football the most money.
Football, so I was like, football it is then. Yeah.
What did kickboxers earn?
But did you win the three fights?
Of course.
He won the three fights.
Technical knockout. Callum, great time.
Thank you.
Top man. That was, of course, making it pro with Callum Wilson and EA Sports FIFA 20.